waste of my mind. A tree made leafless by this wintry wind shall never don again its green array. Chapel and fireside, country, road, and bay have something of their friendliness resigned. Another, if I would, I could not find, and I am grown much older in a day. Yet I treasure in my memory your gift of charity, your mellow ease, and the dear honor of your empty. For these once mine, my life is rich with these, and I scarce know which part may greater be, but I keep of you, or you rob of me. This, sometime at eve, by Elizabeth Clark. At eve, when the tide is low, I shall slip my mooring and sail away with no response to the friendly hail of kindred craft in the busy bay. Silent hush of the twilight pale, when the night stoops down to embrace the day, and the voices call in the waters flow, sometime at eve, when the tide is low, I shall slip my mooring and sail away. The purpling shadows that darkly trail o'er the ebbing tide of the unknown sea. I shall fare me away with the dip of a sail and a ripple of waters to tell the tale of a lonely voyager sailing away to the mystic isles where at anchor lay the crafts of those who have sailed before o'er the unknown sea, the unseen shore. You who have watched me sail away will miss my craft from the busy bay, some friendly barks that were anchored near, some loving souls that my heart held dear, in silent sorrow will drop a tear. But I shall have peacefully furled my sail in mooring shelter from storm or gale, and greeted the friends who have sailed before o'er the unknown sea to the unseen shore. Last poem was read often at the funerals of presidents. So, because I know you love poetry, one more. First, Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit." W.S. Merwin, the American poet, wrote a poem called "The Anniversary of My Death." And you know, we celebrate our birthdays every year. But the date in which we're going to die passes us by every year, and we don't know it. And so he wrote this: "Every year without knowing if I have passed the day when the last fires will wave to me and the silence will set out tireless traveler like the beam of a lightless star, then I will no longer find myself in life as in a strange garment, surprised at the earth in the love of one woman and the shamelessness of men, as today writing after 3 days of rain, hearing the wren sing and the falling cease, bowing, not known to what." So here we are, this almost final moment, because really you're all going to go on and continue the celebration and share some food and conversation about Ed. But all that conversation about death and our end is not an event that separates us from Ed or one another. It is a conversation that shares our essence of being human, and our condition is our mortality. And as Paul the Apostle reminds us, we will not all die, but we will be changed in the twinkling of an eye. Will you pray with me? Oh God, support us all the day long of our troubled life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, and the fever of life is over, and our work is done. And then, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last, through Jesus the Christ. Amen. Now we say goodbye. Holy mystery, who imbues all things with your touch, we commend to your care the body and breath of Ed Bloomfield. Seeker, laugh giver, boa wearer, friend, confidant, beloved father and husband and grandfather, may peace be his, may joy be his mercy robe, and may we always remember that love itself is both first and last. And let the people say,
Amen. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this now concludes the committal services for Dr. Edward H. Bloomfield. On behalf of his family, I wish to express their gratitude for your many, many kindnesses, evidenced both in your thoughts and in your deeds, and certainly for your attendance at today's service. The other director and I are handing out flowers. We would ask that if you'd like to come by, watch your step, place a flower on the casket as a farewell gesture to Dr. Bloomfield, then we invite you on to your cars. As you can see, it's kind of tight here in the parking, so as people begin to egress, it makes it easier for everyone to leave. Okay, and we'll ask that you come in a clockwise fashion, this way to the casket and on.
Oh, that's amazing.
Oh my
Hello, good friend. How are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Awesome.